Welcome to class 10th biology. And in last class, I have already told you about the reproduction and types of vegetative propagations in case of plants. That is a type of asexual reproduction in case of plants. And today you will be learning about asexual reproduction methods in case of single-celled organisms. As you all already learned about the definition of asexual reproduction, it is a type of reproduction in which only single organism is involved. And from that single organism, the new offsprings are formed which are exactly same to the parent cell. And today you will be learning about the asexual reproduction in case of single cell, that is unicellular organisms. Before learning that, there are some characteristics of asexual reproduction. Characteristics means what? With this asexual reproduction, how the organism will form a new individual, what are its characters. So firstly, it involves only one single organism, okay? It involves only one parent, means it involves only one type of organism. And secondly, there is no formation and fusion of gametes. Gametes means there is no involvement of reproductive cells. Gametes are the reproductive cells. In the single cell organism, there are no different types of organs. Its body is made up of only one cell. So, in this asexual method, the organism does not form any kind of reproductive cells and there is no fusion. Means, there is no mating of those reproductive cells. Only one organism is involved and there is no formation and fusion of gametes. Nextly, the young ones formed are almost identical to each other as well as the parent organism. Means, the newly formed organism are exactly same type of the parent cell and also to the another type, means from one organism two or more organisms, new organisms are formed which are similar among them and also to the parent cell. Okay. Next, asexual reproduction generally occurs during favorable environment conditions, means only favorable environment conditions, means when there is availability of proper water, air and proper temperature. This asexual reproduction takes place at that time only in the single cell organisms as well as in multicelled organisms. And it is a faster method of reproduction. It is faster method when compared to the sexual reproduction method. Okay. And this asexual reproduction, it is having certain types in case of single cell organism, unicellular organisms. There are certain different types of methods. First one is binary fission. The meaning of fission means cell division. In this, the cell will divide and from the one single cell, two identical new organisms are formed. Okay. Binary means two. Fission means division of cell. By the help of a division of cell, two identical types of organisms are formed. In this, binary fission takes place in a organism, amoeba. Okay. In amoeba, it is a single cell organism. So, in this method, firstly, the nucleus of the cell, this, whatever you are seeing now, this is a nucleus. This nucleus of the cell will divide first. And after that, jelly-like substance, that is matrix, whatever you are seeing inside the amoeba, that is called a cytoplasm. And firstly, the nucleus will divide. After that, this cytoplasm contents will divide. And in this asexual method of reproduction, that is binary fission, division of nucleus and also division of the cytoplasm takes place. Division of nucleus is called as karyokinesis and division of cytoplasm is called as cytokinesis. So, in this asexual methods of reproduction, both division of nucleus as well as division of cytoplasm takes place. So, in all these three methods, not only in binary fission, multiple fission and budding, in these methods of asexual reproduction, these two steps are common. What I said, first is nucleus will divide and then secondly cytoplasm will divide. First, we will be learning about the binary fission. In this, what happens from a single cell amoeba, this is amoeba cell and this is a nucleus. This is a parent cell amoeba. Like this, firstly, this division of a nucleus takes place. And this cell outer covering of the amoeba, it is also forms a elongation. And next third step, what happens? You can see from one nuclei, two nuclei are formed. Okay. Next fourth step, what happens? Along with once the nuclei will divide and it gets separated, along with this all cytoplasmic contents also will divide. They will also get separated and forms like this small elongation of this outer cell membrane. And this cytoplasm contents will get distributed equally. And this from a single amoeba, two identical amoeba cells are formed, which are similar to each other. These two are similar to each other and also to the parent cell. Okay, understood? From the single amoeba cell, two identical same type of amoeba, daughter amoeba cells are formed. So this is binary fission. From the single division of a single cell, two identical types of cells are formed. This is about the binary fission. Understood? Next, moving on to second one, multiple fission. This multiple fission, what happens? Fission means, as I have already told you, fission means division of a cell. And multiple means from a division of a single cell, many daughter cells are formed. Okay. This is the second type of asexual reproduction in a single cell organism, that is Plasmodium. Plasmodium is a malarial parasite. It will cause us malaria disease. And this Plasmodium organism, it will form more than 8 to 10 cells. But during this process, what happens? Plasmodium organism, at the time of asexual reproduction, these are multiple fission, what happens? This Plasmodium will develop one hard outer covering. This outer covering to protect the parent cell, because due to unfavorable conditions, what happens? It has to protect the new organisms that are formed. And due to these unfavorable conditions, to protect those daughter cells, the parent cell will develop a hard covering around itself. And once this hard covering is called as cyst. Once this cyst is developed, the parent cell will divide and it will form more than 8 to 10 daughter cells. And after these cells are formed, these cells are nothing but daughter Plasmodium organisms. And once these are formed, when the availability of proper temperature and water is taking place in nature, at that time, this organism will break the cyst wall. This cyst wall will get breaks. This will cleave and daughter cells are released in the environment. Okay. Like this, from a single parent cell, more than 8 to 10 new daughter cells are formed. This type of asexual reproduction we call as a multiple fission. From a single organism, more than 8 to 10 organisms are formed. And during unfavorable conditions, to protect the daughter cell, the parent cell will develop a cyst wall. That is a hard covering to protect the organism from unfavorable conditions. Once the cells, new organisms are formed and conditions become favorable, that parent cell will cleave the cyst wall. It will break open and all the newly formed daughter cells will be present. No, they will come out from that cyst wall and they will grow as a new individuals. Understood? This is about the second type of asexual reproduction in Plasmodium. It is also single cell organism. Next, moving on to third one, that is budding. This is a type of asexual reproduction that will take place in the yeast. It is a fungi. And in this, what happens? Yeast cell, it will develop a small outgrowth over its surface. This is yeast cell, parent cell. It will develop a small outgrowth. This outgrowth we call as a bud. And during this process, what happens? The nucleus of the yeast cell will divide. It will cleave and forms two nuclei. And this bud, whatever it is formed, no? All the nucleus which is divided, it will slowly move towards the outgrowth that is formed. And along with the nucleus, all the cytoplasm contents will also get moved towards the outgrowth. And this outgrowth will get all the nourishment and all the necessary materials for its growth from the parent yeast cell. And once it will get all the nutrition from the parent cell, it will get all the nourishment along with the cell contents, nucleus and all. And after that, what happens? The yeast, this bud will get separated from the parent cell and it will grow as a new yeast organism. That is a newly formed individual in the environment. Only during favorable conditions. Okay. When the conditions become proper supply of water, nutrients and temperature, only at that time this outgrowth will get detached from the parent yeast cell and will grow as a new young yeast organism. Otherwise, what happens? The yeast cell will form a chain of buds. If the conditions are not favorable, the yeast cell will be continuously dividing and forming more amount of outgrowths like this. And they will form a chain here. If the conditions are not favorable, then these yeast cell will form a chain of buds. Otherwise, these newly formed bud will be there, no? That will be getting glazed in the environment and it will be forming a new identical organism. It will grow like that. Only if there is proper supply of temperature, water and all nutrients. Otherwise, it will form a chain of buds. Understood? Budding means a small outgrowth is formed over the parent organism and that outgrowth we call as bud. And that bud will get all the essential nutrients from the parent yeast cell along with the nucleus content and cytoplasm contents. Once it will grow and it will completely become matured, that will get detached from the parent yeast cell and it will grow as a new identical organism. This is about budding. Understood? And if the conditions are not proper, that like this chain of buds are formed over the yeast cell. Otherwise, it will get separated. This is about highly favorable conditions. When there is more availability of all nutrients, so it will form a chain of buds. Otherwise, it will separate itself from the parent cell and it will grow as an identical organism. Yeast cell, highly favorable conditions, so it will form chain. Otherwise, it will not form a chain of buds. First, understand this one clearly. Okay. More amount of favorable conditions is there, then only it will form like this chain of buds. If the conditions are not proper, it will get detached from the parent cell and it will grow as an identical yeast new organism. This is about budding. And these are the three steps of asexual reproduction methods in a single cell organisms, unicellular organisms. And in the next class, you will be learning about the asexual reproduction in multicellular organisms. Understood?